you to perform an experiment of BSc 73 inorganic chemistry. The aim of our experiment is determination of acetic acid in commercial vinegar using Henewitt solution. Here the chemicals required are commercial vinegar sample solution, 0.1 normal Henewitt solution, phenolphthalein indicator, and 0.1 normal oxalic acid solution. Now the principle involved in this experiment is the vinegar sample is 4 to 10% acid solution, and how it is estimated by titrating with standard NaOH solution, which previously standardized with oxalic acid solution. Oxalic acid is a primary standard here. Now, what are the reactions involved? So, as this is a acid-base titration, here the acetic acid reacts with sodium hydroxide to give sodium acetate, that is salt and water. Now the requirements related to this experiment are conical flask, 100 ml volumetric flask, funnel, beaker, burette, pipette. The chemicals are the oxalic acid solution, sodium hydroxide solution, vinegar sample solution, and phenolphthalein as an indicator. The procedure here, it involves three steps. First step is the preparation of standard oxalic acid solution. Second step is the titration of oxalic acid with sodium hydroxide solution. And the third step is the titration of sodium hydroxide with diluted vinegar solution. Now here in step 1, we have to prepare 0.1 mol 100 ml oxalic acid solution. For this, we know the equivalent weight of oxalic acid is 63 grams. So as per the calculation, in 100 ml, we have to take 0.63 grams of oxalic acid for the preparation of 0.1 normal solution. So here, in the second step, titration of this oxalic acid versus NaOH solution. Here in above step, this 0.3 grams of oxalic acid is taken in volumetric flask, and then we have to make up the volume. Now, in second step, we have to titrate this oxalic acid with NaOH solution to find the exact normality of NaOH solution. For this, we have to fill the burette with sodium hydroxide solution, take 10 ml of acetic acid in conical flask and 2 drops of indicator, and then titrate till the color changes from colorless to just light pink, and we have to take 3 constant readings. In step 3, now the titration of this standard NaOH solution has been carried out with vinegar solution containing the acetic acid. Here, 10 ml of vinegar solution is taken in conical flask, 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator, then titrate with NaOH solution till same color changes from colorless to pink solution. And we have to take out 3 constant readings. Now, we will see on table how 0.63 grams of oxalic acid is to be measured. Measure 0.63 gram. Measure 0.63 grams of oxalic acid. For this, we have to use this digital weighing machine. First, we have to calibrate it by setting the 0. So now 0 set. Take 0.63 grams of oxalic acid. Grams of oxalic acid. Okay. approximately 0.63 grams. So this is 0.63 grams of oxalic acid. Now we have weighed 0.63 grams of oxalic acid. Now we have to prepare 0.1 normal of oxalic acid solution. For this we have to take this volumetric flask of 100 ml. Here it is its graduation. Add this 0.63 grams of oxalic acid that we have measured. Make up the volume with distilled water. Slowly add the distilled water along the sides of the funnel so that all the oxalic acid it goes down. Then shake it to form a homogeneous mixture. So now make up the volume up to 100 ml with intermittent shaking. So this is 0.1 normal oxalic acid solution. Now, as for the second step, we have to now titrate this oxalic acid solution with NaOH solution. Here in burette, we have filled the sodium hydroxide solution. Take this. Oxalic acid in a conical flask. Needless to say that all the apparatus has been properly washed prior to use. Add phenolphthalein indicator. As it is acid based titration, so here we have to add phenolphthalein indicator. Just 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Phenolphthalein indicator remains colorless in this acid solution. Now we have to titrate. For this, some air bubbles should be priorly removed. So this precaution we have to take. For the colorless solutions, generally we consider the lower meniscus. Now start the titration dropwise. So here just we get a color change from colorless. So here we just got color change from colorless to pink. Here our burette reading is 10 ml. We repeat this experiment 3 times to get the constant reading. Now step 3. In step 3 we have to take this 10 ml of vinegar solution containing the acetic acid. So this 10 ml of vinegar solution is containing the acetic acid. In this we have to add this phenolphthalein indicator, 2 to 3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Same, we have to titrate it with standard NaOH solution till the color changes from colorless to pink. So here we observe a just color change, just light pink color. It is the end point. So a neutralization reaction takes place, and showing the end point here, the reading is 14, and we repeat this experiment 3 times to get the constant reading. So after the practical performance and titrations on table, now we move towards the observation and calculation part. So from step 2, that is the titration of oxalic acid versus NaOH, here in the first volume of NaOH, that is the burette reading, firstly we get 10, then 9 ml, then 11 ml. So the constant volume we get is 10 ml. And from step 3, that is the titration of the standardized NaOH versus unknown vinegar, that is acetic acid, we get here the readings 13 ml, 14 ml and 15 ml, that is the burette reading, and the constant reading is 14 ml. Okay? Now about the calculation part. So from step 1, here this is the formula is N1V1 is equals to N2V2. N1V1 is equals to N2V2. Here N1 is the normality of oxalic acid, that is 0.1 normal. V1 is the volume of oxalic acid, that is 10 ml. N2 is the normality of NaOH that we have to find out. And V2 is the burette reading here, that is the 10 ml. Okay? So this is substituting the values in the formula, that is N2 is equals to N1 into V1 upon V2. Here N2 is calculated, that is the exact normality of NaOH solution, here is 0.1 norm. Now in step 2 we are using this NaOH which is having the exact normality of 0.1 norm. Okay? Here 1000 ml of 1 normal NaOH consists of 60 grams of acetic acid. So V2 dash ml, okay, so this is V2 dash, okay, this is V2 10 ml and this is V2 dash. So V2 dash ml N2 normal NaOH is equals to 60 into V2 dash into N2 upon 1000. So it is a formula. From this we get W, that is the W grams of acetic acid. So now W grams of acetic acid is present in 10 ml of vinegar. Okay? So in 100 ml vinegar, how much it is present? That is 60 into 14 into 0.1 upon 1000. Okay? 60 is what? That is the equivalent weight of acetic acid. Here 14 is V2 dash into 0.1 normal upon 1000. So here W value is 0.084 grams. So now acetic acid in 100 ml solution is 0.084 multiplied by 10, it is 0.84 grams. Percentage acetic acid is 10 into W into 100 upon 10 percentage. So final reading is 8.4 percentage. So our result reporting is 8.4% of acetic acid is present in given vinegar solution. So this was all about our aim of the experiment, that is the determination of acetic acid in commercial vinegar using NaOH solution. Thank you.